Jesus, we praise you, Lord.
Let's lift those hands. Hallelujah. Just tell God something nice. Just tell God something good. Just worship God. He's worthy to be praised. Just worship Him for all that He has done. Hallelujah. God has been good, and we do have a lot to thank Him for, and to praise Him for, and to lift Him up for, because He is so good. Hallelujah. Praise God. Somebody shout Jesus.
Jesus.
Somebody shout Jesus.
For he had been dead 4 days.
Jesus said unto her, said I not unto thee that if thou wouldest believe, thou shouldest see the glory of God? Then they took away the stone from the place where the dead was laid. And Jesus lifted up his eyes and said, Father, I thank thee that thou hast heard me, and I know that thou hearest me always. But because of the people which stand by, I said it, that they may believe that thou hast sent me. And when he thus had spoken, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth.
Raised from the dead.
dead and buried in the grave for 4 long days. He started to decay.
My God.
I can just imagine the scent.
My Lord.
The stench. In the environment that those people were standing by to watch Jesus perform the miracle. Amen. But the glory is not ours, it is God's glory. Now, a message was sent to Jesus when Lazarus was sick. And the Bible said that Lazarus was really, really sick. And Jesus loved Lazarus. But why didn't Jesus move when he got the message?
My God.
Why? He waited 2 days before he started his journey. His friend who was so sick.
My God.
Big question. Such a huge question. But Jesus waited because he wanted Lazarus to die. I hope you don't start stoning me right now.
Oh my God.
Yes, my name is Stephen. It's called Stephen the Bible, but please bear with me. He wanted Lazarus to die because when he raised him from the dead and told them to remove his grave clothes, there was an anointing in that place. And in everything, you will always have believers and unbelievers.
Yes.
Now, the scripture said that some believe, no, not some, but many believe on him.
Yes.
Which means that they now take the man seriously.
Yes.
And they were all saying,
yes,
this is indeed the Messiah,
yes,
that were prophesied above by the Old Testament writers. So many believe on him, many of the Jews. Yes, sir. And so Jesus went after 2 days passed. He waited for 2 days, ensuring that the man is really dead.
Yes, man.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Now, the journey took 2 days. Waiting 2 days. The journey took 2 days because when we reach here, the scripture said that he has been buried 4 days.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Praise.
Hope you lost it.
Praise.
I have lost it. Amen. Now, the effect of this miracle, was so profound. My God, this miracle knew of some demons that wanted to keep the man bound in the grave. It knew of some wicked people that did not want to see him come up out of the grave. Moved up some preachers who wanted the man to remain dead. But Jesus spoke and Jesus said, Lazarus, come forth. He had to come forth. What? Yes, he had to come forth because Jesus said it. And when Jesus speak, peace is still.
Yes. Hallelujah.
This miracle was not for me. get praise or you to be praised or you to be praised. It was for God to get the glory. Because the glory belongs to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
It is His glory. Every praise belongs to God. Don't praise man. Praise God. Because God is worthy to be praised. Praise God. So I say that the effect that the resurrection had on the people was so powerful that many were saved. But they went their way. And they were afflicted to the hearts.
Yes.
And they were haters. Yes. Demons. But I rebuke every demons in Jesus' name.
Hallelujah.
We don't wrestle against flesh and blood.
Yes.
But against principalities and powers and the rulers of the darkness of this world.
Yes.
Those are the things we wrestle against. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So many believed in verse 45, and some unbelievers, however, went and told the Pharisees. Pharisees now started to plot against Jesus so that they might kill him.
My God.
You will, I'm telling you, you will have haters.
Yes.
Oh, you will go through persecution. If you're not living for God, you're not going to go through anything. But when you are genuinely saying Jesus, you are going to face some things that you are going to wonder what is happening. But God said when these things come, rejoice and be glad and give Him the glory. Because great is your reward in heaven. Scripture said that if this were our final hope, we would be of all men most miserable. I'm telling you, the word of God. I did not say it's the Bible. Because this is not our final hope. We have hope for glory. We have hope for eternal life. We have hope that someday, when God puts in His appearance, we will not hear parts about the nuance, but we will hear, well done, good and faithful servant. Praise God. So Lazarus was risen from the dead. Amen. And God received the glory because the glory belonged unto Him. Glory is not for me or for you. It's not for pastor. It's not for the bishop. It's God's glory.
Yes.
So I give glory to God.
Yes.
The apostles said, should we please man rather than God? Or should we obey man and not obey God? We must obey God. We must do the work of the Lord. This was when the apostles were speaking in the name of Jesus. And they want to shut them up.
Yes.
But they said, obeying man is wrong. But when we obey God, we are sure of our reward.
Praise God.
God. Praise God. Tell your neighbor, the glory belongs to God.
The glory
belongs to God. You on Facebook, the glory belongs to God. It does not belong to you. It does not belong to your boss. It does not belong to your supervisor. It belongs to Jesus, and Jesus is God.
Praise God. Hallelujah.
The glory belongs to God. My God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
Now, some sickness. There are some sickness. They are not unto death. They are not unto death. Right? You might have an ailment right now. And you believe that this is it. I'm going to die now. This is going to take me to my grave. But some sickness says, are you not unto them? Because a thought Lazarus will not come back. Remember, when we die, we say farewell to this world. And so Lazarus said farewell. He was dead. He was buried. It had been 4 days. But Jesus said in verse 4 of St. John 11 that this sickness is not unto death. And there is another scripture, the same chapter, that Jesus said, Lazarus is dead.
My God.
No. He might have been dead physically, but it was not an eternal death. Don't know if you understand what I'm saying. But he might have died physically. Physically is dead. But eternally, he was not dead. Because it was for the purpose of God to be fulfilled.
Praise Him.
And that is what Christ, that is why He stayed for 2 days, ensuring that His promise would be fulfilled.
Yes.
Amen?
Yes.
Because He must receive the glory out of it. So when He came, He said, man, come out from out of the grave. From his grave clothes. Praise God. That was a miracle indeed.
My Lord.
Praise God. And if this message don't speak to somebody today, to come out of your grave.
My God.
Unwrap yourself from your grave clothes.
God bless you.